it's the dark, if love be blind, love cannot hit the mark.
He jests at scars that never felt a wound.
But soft, what light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair sun, and kill the envious moon, who's already but sick and pale with grief. That thou hast made her far more fair than she, be not her babe, since she's envious. Her vestal livery is sick and green, and none but fools to wear it cast it off. It is my lady, oh, it is my love, oh, that she knew she were. Two of the fairest stars in all the heaven, having some business to entreat her eyes to twinkle in their spheres to their return. What if her eyes were there? There in her head, the brightness of her cheek would shame those stars as daylight doth a lamp. And through the airy region streams so bright, the birds would sing and think it were not night. Oh, see how she leans her cheek upon her hand, that I were a glove upon her hand, that I might touch that cheek.
Ay, me.
She speaks. Speak again, bright angel.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Did thy father refuse thy name? Or if thou wilt not, but be sworn my love, and I will no longer be a Capulet.
Shall I hear more, or shall I speak of this?
It is but thy name that is my enemy. Thou art thyself, no, not Montague. What is Montague? It is nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part belonging to a man. Oh, be some other name! What's in a name? That which we call a rose by any other name is really sweet. So, Romeo, were he not Romeo called, retain that dear perfection to which he owes without that title. Oh, Romeo, doff thy name, and for that name which is no part of thee, take all myself.
I take thee at thy word, call me beloved, and I'll be new baptized. Henceforth, I will never be Romeo.
What man art thou that is discreet tonight to stumble upon my counsel?
By a name, I know not how to tell thee who I am. My name, dear saint, is hateful to myself, because it is an enemy to thee. Had I it written, it would tear the word.
My ears have not yet shrunk 100 words of that tongue's utterance, yet I know the sound. Art thou not Romeo and a Montague?
Neither, if either thee dislike.
How camest thou hither? Tell me, and wherefore? The orchard walls are high and hard to climb, and a place of death concerning whom thou art, if any of my kinsmen find thee here.
With love's light wings did it o'er perch these walls, for stony limits cannot pull love out. And what love can do that dares love attempt? Therefore thy kinsmen are no let to me.
If they see thee, they will murder thee.
Alack, there lies more pale in thine eyes than 20 of their swords. Look thou but sweet, and I proof against their enemy.
I would not for the world they saw thee here.
They have knight's cloak to hide me from their sight. And if thou love me, let them find me here. My life is better ended by their hate than death prorogued wanting of thy love.
By whose direction found'st thou at this place?
By love, who first did prompt you to inquire. He lent me counsel, and I lent him eyes. I am no pilot, yet wert thou as far as the vast shore washed from the farthest sea, I would adventure for such merchandise.
Thou knowest the mask of night is on thy face. Else would a maiden gladly paint my cheek for that which thou hast heard me speak tonight. Fain deny what I have spoke. But farewell, compliment. Dost thou love me? I know thou wilt say aye, and I will take thy word. But if thou swearest, thou mayest be false. A lover's perjury is, they say, Jove laughs. O gentle Romeo, thou dost love, pronounce faithfully. Or if thou thinkest I'm too quickly won, I'll frown and be perverse and say thee nay. So thou wilt woo, but else not for the world. In truth, fair Montague, I am too fond. So therefore thou mayest think my behavior light. But trust me, gentlemen, I'll be more true than those who have more cunning to be strange. I should have been more strange, I must confess. But that thou overheardest, ere I was aware, my true love's passion, therefore pardon me, and not impute this yielding to light love which the dark night hath so discovered.
Lady, by yonder blessed moon, I swear that tips with silver all these fruit tree tops.
Swear not by the moon, the inconstant moon that monthly changes in a circle o'er, lest that thy love prove likewise variable.
What shall I swear by?
Do not swear at all. Or if thou wilt, swear by thy gracious self, which is the god of my idolatry.
If my heart's thee love.
Do not swear. Though I join thee, I have no joy in this contract tonight. It is too rash, too unadvised, too sudden. Too much that the lightning which doth cease to be
Lilac's faithful vow for mine.
I gave thee mine before thou didst request it, and yet I would have were to give it again.
Wouldst thou withdraw it? For what purpose, love?
To be frank, and to give it to thee again. My bounty is as boundless as the sea. My love is deep.